Going back to the financial markets, Philippine shares continuing their winning streak for a second straight day. The main index gaining 0.75% to close at 60.73. Now, to help us make sense of today's market movements, we're joined live by Jemima Alfonso of Regina Capital. Hi, Jemima. Good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
All right.
It's a pleasure to be back.
Pleasure to have you back. So we seem to be comfortably perched above 6,000. Do you think 6,000 is a strong support now? And how much more upside are you expecting from the upcoming earnings season?
Well, I would say the market is just generally like flat right now as the market participants are looking forward to the Fed's next policy meeting, which would be on November 2. And Philippine time, that would be on November 3 at 2 a.m. So for the past trading days, we did see some rallies across the local shares. However, the volume has been pretty thin, and this hints that investors are still very cautious in entering the market. So with that, I don't think that the 6K level would be a strong support, considering that the BSP could rate hike aggressively in the coming months. So with regards to the earnings, Wilcon already released their third quarter report, and their figures are better than expected with the help of their strategic price adjustments. So generally, we are expecting healthy figures for the third quarter earnings across the firms. And considering that the macro headwinds the past few months, analysts' forecasts are probably conservative for the third quarter. So it's now easier to outperform the estimates, and this could propel the stocks to rally.
Yeah, we're flashing now earnings from Wilcon Depot. It reminds me, it's very similar to BPI, because BPI did report a 74% jump as well in earnings. So it's the same for Wilcon. Third quarter net income up 77% to 1.1 billion. That's an additional over 400 million peso profit. Revenue there jumping 33%, 8.8. This brings the 9-month net income to nearly 3 billion pesos, up by about 60%. So you think that this is how the third quarter earnings season will go, that it's going to be impressive numbers after impressive numbers? Or do you discriminate between certain sectors that are likely to outperform versus some sectors who might take a harder beating from thinning margins because of inflation?
Well, I think the earnings would be healthy. It's not going to spike, but it's going to better than we expect, because again, we've been thinking that the third quarter would be bad, but then analysts would probably lower their
expectations.
Would be very modest when it comes to their forecast, when it comes to their estimates. So yeah, we are expecting that the third quarter earnings would be healthy.
All right, that's the thing about setting expectations. You set them too high, it's so easy to underperform. But set the expectations just right, it's going to be very easy to beat. And it's all about beating and sentiment for the markets. Speaking of sentiment, and you mentioned this earlier, the Banco Central is expected to be aggressive. They did voice their commitment, you know, to aggressively hike rates for the remainder of the year, in tandem with the Fed. So if the Fed does a 75 basis points, the BSP says we're ready to match that to keep the differential between our rates in the US and in the Philippines at 100 basis points. Is that good for risk assets, or will that do more harm?
Well, I think the BSP's plan to be more aggressive will drag equities even further to the south. Mm-hmm. Finance Secretary Jokma said that the government, again, wouldn't allow the peso to breach 60. So it is likely that the rates would surge in the remaining months of the year. And yeah, this could prompt investors to be cash heavy and be bystanders until risks will kind of die down or ease.
Mm-hmm. And the expectation is maybe end of the year or next year, at least the Fed starts to slow down. So how low can we go? If the expectation is for hawkish central banks, how low can the index go for the remainder of the year? Remember, the number to beat is 71.22, just to be able to break even from last year's close.
Well, we are seeing the 5,800 level to be the stronghold for the index.
5,800. All right, that's it. Okay, I'm not going to say any more about 5,800. That might alarm others. But let's go back to the other earnings that we have. If we could just pull up the earnings. So we've got Wilcon Depot. We've also got Medco Holdings. Medco Holdings reporting net loss there, managing to narrow for the third quarter as well as for the 9 months of the year. Revenue there doing pretty well, up 2,000%. The gains there in revenue mainly due to forex gains, but as you can see, it's still net loss for this company. And let's go over to Asia now. The Asian benchmark today is nursing losses of what? Nearly 32% so far this year, weighed by big falls in Hong Kong shares. Well, you've got emerging markets like India, Indonesia gaining on improving growth prospects. How are we doing foreign fund flows wise? How is the Philippine market, looking like when it comes to how attractive we are to foreign fund flows?
Well, the FDI sank and hit the 14-month low just recently, but this is generally driven by the looming global outlook. But I don't think that we are behind. The macro outlook is just like overall looking bad. So investors domestically and externally are just very cautious.
When are you expecting hot money to flow back in?
Well, I couldn't say like any estimate right now, but hopefully, if the inflation will kind of like ease, then we are expecting foreign funds to flow again.
All right. And final question, fearless forecast on the peso. The peso won't touch 60 this year. Yes or no?
Okay, so that's a tough question, but I would say that the BSP affirmed that the peso wouldn't touch the 60 area. So I believe that they could rate hike very aggressively in the coming months, so just to stay true in this promise. So that's why we could assume that there could be a rocky market in the remaining months of the year. So yeah, we have faith in the BSP. So they will probably stay true to their promise.
All right. And one more interesting corporate story is we have this just in. A bake shop, Red Ribbon Bake Shop under the Jollibee Group, actually opening its 39th location in the US. And this one happens to be in Philadelphia. It's actually her first branch in Philadelphia. Just very quickly, your take on Jollibee. Jollibee used to be the favorite darling consumer stock. It was trading at 30 times price to earnings, but people didn't mind paying, so much premium for this brand. Is this still a darling, a market darling?
Well, JFC, when the market plunged, this was very, I would say, very resilient during the sell down. So I would say Jollibee, it's still pretty much still good to play, to trade. So yeah.
All right. On that note, Jemima, it was a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you.